last island. And it's by far the shortest. Okay, so once again, don't look at the sheet. Yep. Back and forth twice, listen. Kempesinga Oyon. Nayon Peut. William Taylor. That's it. So Kempesinga Oyon. Nayon Peut. William Taylor. Okay. Slalamsara? Say so that's that. Very nice. Okay, so Kempesinga is a really good thing to memorize. What are you doing? Kempesinga. Kempe is what action, what deed. And this is the doer, this is a verbalizer. And I would just learn it just the way it is now. Kempesinga. Everybody, Kempesinga. Kempesinga.
Kempesinga.
Okay, what are you doing? What's the answer? Oweyom.
Oweyom.
Uh-huh. And what's the person doing?
Eating.
What are you doing? I'm eating. Oweyom. Ngalyom peut. Ngalyom peut. Okay. This you know. What is this?
It's peut, isn't it?
What?
What thing would be?
Yeah. So this is simply what. This is what? And this is you. But why does it have the L? Okay, so that's what we're going to study at the very last thing today. I know it looks weird, but it actually makes sense in the whole system. And the answer is William Taylor. William Taylor. I'm eating what?
Taylor,
very famous Taylor. I wish I knew more about Pandoran food.
Just like Grandma's Taylor.
Just like Grandma's Taylor, exactly. Exactly. We have to learn how to say that in Na'vi. Okay, so this is one of the things that makes Na'vi grammar unique. And when I constructed the language, I wanted to put something in it that would be possible and would make sense, but would be relatively rare. The only Earth languages that I know that do it this way are found in Australia. There's some native, well, beardy, I think. I got the wrong name. Anyway, the point is that it's a very rare phenomenon. It's called the tripartite case system. Okay, and I learned about it from my dissertation advisor, who is an expert in this kind of stuff, and I said, that'd be kind of cool to put into the language. So here's what's going on. Owe yom. Owe, everybody knows, right? Okay. I am eating. Notice there's no object. I'm just talking about an action. There's no object involved. If I'm walking, there's no action. You don't say, oh, you're walking? What are you walking? It doesn't make any sense. I'm sleeping. What are you sleeping? It doesn't make any sense. Okay. Verbs like that are called, what's it?
Intransitive.
Intransitive means they don't have an object. They simply, just the action. If it's just the action, you use the simple form of the subject. Oe. Oe nga. Okay. Now, this is different. And this is different. Because here, for example, I'm eating something. And it does make sense to say, what are you eating? So in this particular case, you have an object. This will be called the agent. The agent is the one that's doing something to something else. Okay? So you have agent. You have object. When you have agent and object in Na'vi, there are special forms for the agent and for the object. So the agent takes an L, and it comes out well, and the object, which is normally just telu, takes a T. Telu. And you just have to get used to it. But after a while, you will. So again, if there's an object, and by the way, that's not a transitive verb, that's not an intransitive verb, that's a transitive verb. So with transitive verbs, where the object is present, the agent takes an L, the object takes a T. So let's actually try this, it's really easy. Everybody, Kempesinga.
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 Owe yo. Nalion peut. Nalion peut. Peut is what with the object form, because nal is the agent. You are doing something to something. You are eating what? What thing? That's the object. That's the agent. L T. Nalion peut. Okay. U is thing. And we said that the interrogative to say what thing, you simply add what?
Pe.
Pe. So add pe in front. But pe is one of these things that triggers lenition. So what do I have to do? Drop the glottal stop. And then I simply have peu. So peu is simply what? What thing? What? Now, in the object form, then, it'd be peut. Now, this will be for another time, but just so you know, the pe, like many things in Na'vi, can either come in the front or in the back. So I could say pe plus u, or I could say u plus pe. That's okay. Now, in this case, does lenition take place?
No.
No, there's no reason, because it's not in front of anything. So I retain the glottal stop. So that would be upe. And then the object form would be upe. So you can either say, peut, or you can say upe. Peut. Everybody try it. Peut. Peut. And try to hold the T at the end, don't release it. Peut. Upet. I mean exactly the same, whichever you like. Okay, so let's try it with peut. Nalion peut. Nalion peut. The other way. Nalion upet. Nalion upet. Same thing, either way. Okay, so that's simply the pattern. No object, simple. Just the subject form. With the object, you have L for the agent and T for the patient. So this is just showing you agent L, patient T. When a verb is transitive, has an object, not has special forms for the agent and the object, L form for the agent. We just went over that. Okay. What do the forms look like? Okay, I'm not going to go into a lot of detail on this. Depending upon whether it ends in a vowel or a consonant, it's sometimes L, it's sometimes ill. So if it's neitiri, which ends in a vowel, to make her an agent, you simply add an L. Neitiril, neitiril. If it's etukan, etukan, I can't say etukan, I have to add a vowel there. Etukanil. So it ends in a consonant, ill, it ends in a vowel. That's the very basic idea. There are a few little complications, but don't worry about it now. Forms of the patient of the T form. Sometimes it's just T, sometimes it's eat, sometimes it's TI. So if it's neitiri in a patient form, she's the object. If I see neitiri, well, se a, I see, well, se a, neitirit with a T. I could also say welcia neitiriti. That's okay. The eat is if it ends in a consonant. If I say etukan, welcia etukani. And I can also say etukanti. So T is used in almost all cases. In other cases, you can choose between the and eat. We can talk about the complications later on, but right now we only have a few more minutes. I just want to practice this a little bit. So this will be the very last content slide, and this will give us a little bit of room to practice. It'll be the last thing we'll do today. So here are some verbs. Let's just repeat the verbs together. Yom.
Yom.
Nat.
Nat.
Inan.
Inan.
M.
M.
Kar. Ftia. Okay, we have someone who knows Ftia very well here. Ftia Fpi? Okay, what are the meanings? I didn't actually put the meanings down. Yom? Nak? Inan. Inan means read. Now, the Na'vi don't have books, so why should they have a word for read? Well, they read things, but not necessarily books. What do they read? They read the forest. Okay, they get information from the forest. So this is a general term of getting information from sensory input. So you can read animal tracks, you can read the air. I don't know. You can read a lot of things. Okay, M? Cook. M is cook. Kar?
Teach.
Ftia?
Study.
Okay, so eat, drink, read, cook, teach, study. Okay, those are some verbs. Okay, here are some possible objects that might go along with some of those verbs. Okay, everybody, suve.
Suve.
Means what?
Food.
Telu, everybody knows. Okay, excuse me, this is a little tricky to pronounce. Fken, try it.
Fken.
What does it mean?
Vegetables.
Okay, these are vegetable foods, veggies. Naer.
Naer.
What's that? General term for beverage. So, suve, food, naer, beverage. Okay, some particular beverages, pie. What's that?
Water.
Ir.
Beer.
Beer. Okay, I assume the Na'vi don't quite have the same kind of beer we do if they have beer at all. So, anyway, this is obviously from the English, right? Okay, suoa. Intoxicating beverage, okay, possibly alcohol. I don't know exactly what the chemistry would be. Okay, everyone, upare.
Upare.
What does that mean?
Message.
Upare, message. This one you may not know. Tsmim. What's tsmim? Tsmim is an animal track. Okay, so obviously some of these go well with some of these. Yeti.
Yeti.
Okay, everybody knows Yeti. And finally, Litfia Lena'vi. Litfia Lena'vi. Why did I include Yeti with these verbs?
Eat it.
I guess you can eat it, yeah. Okay. Okay. Okay.
Or you can do Yeti and track. But you don't have any probate track.
Okay. So, Matt.
So I was actually wondering just yesterday. I took a few years of Japanese in high school and college, and one of the things that I quickly learned is that when you're talking about eating an animal and you're talking about the animal, there's two different words.
Yeah.
Is this not going to be? Is this not that way?
I don't think it's going to be that way.
But would you have words?
There probably are, and I don't know enough about Na'vi cooking yet to be able to tell you. Eventually, hopefully, we will have more answers to those questions. But that's the kind of stuff that I need to talk to the big guy about and find out. But yeah, and of course we have the same thing in English, right? What are you having tonight? We're having cow. Okay, we don't say that, right? What do you think? We have the beef. Okay, so yeah, so there, the animal and the meat is a little different. Okay, so last thing we're going to do, we're going to have very simple little dialogues based on that really short one. So, kempesinga, 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 oe m. Ngal m peut. Ngal m. Peut. What does that mean?
What are you cooking?
Okay. Kempesinga, what are you doing? That's not going to change. Kempesinga, oe, am. What are you doing? I am cooking. Ngal em peut. You're cooking what? What are you cooking? Ngal em peut. Well, because I'm going to do something to something, well em yeri. Ki, IT. Well, emierikit. Well, emierikit. Okay, let's everybody try that. Everybody. Should speak Na'vi. Mafrapo. Mafrapo. Root eliven. Mafrapo. Root eliven. Please repeat. Kempesinga.
Kempesinga.
O-A-M. O-A-M. Ngal empeut. Ngal empeut. Well em yeriki. Good. Kempesinga. Kempesinga. Oweinan. Oweinan. Okay, I just made a mistake. I said oweinan as if it had a glottal stop. Doesn't have a glottal stop, so therefore I should not make a break. It should be smooth. Oweinan. Oweinan. Ngalinan peut. And I made a mistake again. Oh, peut. No break. Ngalinan peut. Ngalinan peut. Welinan. Welinan smimi. Welinan smimi. Does that mean something? Or? Okay. So let's just have a few little conversations and then we'll call it quits. Okay. So question, answer, question, answer. Whatever you like. Who wants to start? Yeah.
Kempesinga.
You just said Kempesinga.
Weftia.
It's Ftia, isn't it?
Ftia.
Yeah. What well, did I say? Oh. Yeah, it's a question of the stress.
Oh, oh, Ftia.
Yeah. Ftia.
Is the stress of the A?
Yeah.
Oh, Weftia.
Okay. Kempesinga, Weftia. No. So ask him what he's studying.
Yeah.
Okay. You could, that's peut ftiangal. Peut ftiangal. Or that's okay, so so Sven has changed the word order, which is fine. You can do that. Notice in English you put the question word first. We have no choice. Because we could say you're studying what? Normally you say, what are you studying? So you can do it both ways in English, but you can certainly do it in a lot of different ways. And
I guess normally, if the stress is on the last word of the sentence, and it is important to get the information mm-hmm. of what he's studying, I guess I should choose the word order to put the period as the last word, maybe.
Perhaps, yeah. There'll be a lot of situations where you would do that.
Yeah.
Okay. So. Ask a question again.
Nalftia peut.
Nalftia peut.
Well, dia, litvia, litvia ti, Na'vi.
Very good. And so the by the way, this is a little complicated. This is the Na'vi language, right? Litvia, Na'vi. The T for the object goes here because this is the noun. This is the adjective. You never put stuff on adjectives. So it's litvia ti, Na'vi. Welftia litfiati Na'vi. Good. Okay. Let's do one more and then you can practice and you'll lose your time. Okay. Sarah, ask a question.
Oh, you want me
to ask?
Kempesinga?
Kempesinga? Kempesinga? Kempesinga? Yes.
Oweyom.
Oweyom. Kempesinga? Oweyom. Okay. Is there a follow-up question?
Oh. Ngal yom peut.
Okay. Ngal.
Ngal yom peut.
Yeah. Ngal yom peut. Ngal yom peut.
Weyom. Can I use an English word? Weyom. Yeah.
Okay. Now, let's get the L and the T. Okay. So, well.
Well.
Yom.
Weyom.
Yeriki.
Ye,
Yeah, well, yomi eriki. Yeah, okay. Okay, so we could take time to have a little conversations, but you have another couple days. Okay, so get together, have little conversations, practice this stuff, and Luhase, that's it. Etre pasiaivi, good luck. Kivamote wagahu. Kivamit. Very much. Hey, that was fun. Did I totally exhaust everybody? Not too bad. Okay. Good.